This week's podcast is about a Highland distillery known as Dalwhinnie, a little known but highly productive distillery with some great expressions and history. Welcome to Savor Whiskey. I'm not selling and I'm not yelling. I'm here to introduce you to the good life and to hopefully settle your life down and introduce to you an appreciation of the wonderful world of whiskey travel and life's joy. Let's learn about Dalwhinnie. The Victorians described Dalwhinnie as being madly located. Even through modern eyes, it's possible to see where they were coming from. Dalwhinnie is the third highest located distillery in Scotland and the meteorological station that has the distinction of observing the lowest recorded temperature in Britain. The distillery maintains the ability to be completely self-contained in the event of high snows, with an entire hostel located on site to house the staff. Dalwhinnie's isolated location is a key part of its history. Dalwhinnie means meeting place in Gaelic, a nod to the distillery's excellent central location. The Strathspey Distillery Company founded the distillery in 1897 and originally operated under the name Strathspey. Less than a year later, however, the company went into liquidation and the name of the distillery was changed appropriately as it switched hands to the Dalwhinnie Distillery Company. Production continued with the architect Charles Doig, who is responsible for the famous pagoda-shaped roof, contributing to the expansion of the distillery. The distillery changed hands twice more during the first half of the 20th century and was briefly owned by an American company, Cook & Bernheimer, making it the very first foreign-owned Scotch distillery. In 1934, a fire destroyed the majority of the distillery and production had to be halted for 4 years while the site was rebuilt. After the rebuild was completed in 1938, the distillery had to remain closed until 1940 due to wartime restrictions on barley. Since 1940, the distillery has produced whiskey almost uninterrupted, save for a brief period in 1986 when the distillery underwent a complete refurbishment. Today, Dalwhinnie is owned by Diageo and forms part of its classic malts range. The brand has reached great critical acclaim, with the 15-year-old and Distillers Edition being awarded the Mons Selection Gold Medals. Let's do a tasting of Dalwhinnie Winter's Gold for Christmas. To my eye, it's a wonderful pale gold. Your nose knows. I'm smelling some oak spice, pear skins, golden syrup, and gristy malt. A touch of peach polish and chewy, sticky toffee. From the freezer, it's fruitier, more green apple, applesauce, toffee apple, sultana, even recurrent. It's all there in the nose. Let's taste. Slangeavar. Yum. Very nice. Honey with warming peppery spices, big red cinnamon. From the freezer, the honey is kept in check much more, as are the spices. Plenty of apple flesh and orange peel. An elegant combination of flavors. The finish is bright and festive. It's like liquid holidays. Allspice, nutmeg, and smoky malt. From the freezer, the finish is more about the spicy cinnamon and peppercorn heat that's found on the palate at room temperature. This is a fun dram worthy of any family holiday event. With the warmth of the season, your guests will surely appreciate. Relatively gentle and refined, with nice fruity touches. Dalwhinnie recommends chilling it beforehand in the freezer. It's made only with spirit that has been distilled between October and March, and interestingly enough, they suggest that you can try serving this expression of all things, frozen. Thanks for listening. Apologies for any mispronunciation. Gaelic is one of the most difficult languages in the world. Remember to savor whiskey and don't drink and drive. And don't forget to keep learning and loving. Life is too short for having a bad time. Life is about passionate living. Good food, fine whiskey, and great people make you worthy of it all. I'm Carl Cimini for Savor Whiskey. For more information, please visit Savor Whiskey on Facebook or at the website savorwhiskey.com to find out about Scotland, whiskey, and tastings in your area. And always remember, savor whiskey with friends and thusly, savor the good life. Happy holidays to all.